Hello, Sairam students. Okay, let us continue again today with chapter 5, that is fractions, multiplication and division. And today we'll be doing part 3 of this chapter. Okay, now in the last class, students, we have already studied how to find fraction of a whole number, as well as we have also learned to find the product by multiplying two fractions. Correct? So today, let us continue and learn to find the product or by multiplication of more than two fractions. And also we'll learn about the properties of multiplication of fractions. Okay? So now before we start, just remember that we multiply more than two fractions in the same way as we multiply two fractions. That is, we multiply the numerators together and the denominators together. Also remember to cancel the common factors before actually finding the product. Okay, so let us start with an example here. Okay, here you have to multiply 2 upon 3, 5 upon 6 and 7 upon 11. Okay. So, I'll write the fractions here. Okay. So, 2 upon 3 multiplied by 5 upon 6 multiplied by 7 upon 11. Okay. Now, here just you can cancel 2 and 6. That is, 6 is easily divisible by 2. So, 2 ones are 2. Okay. 2 threes are is 6. Now, is there any other number which is divisible? Common factor? No. So, here you can multiply. That is 5. Multiply the numerators. 5 into 7 into 1. And here you will multiply 3 into 3 into 11. So, your answer is 5 sevens are is 35. 35 ones are 35. Upon 3 threes are 9 and 9 elevens are is 99. So you have to multiply the same way how you used to multiply the two fractions. Here it is more than two fractions. Okay. Now let us start with exercise 5.2. Okay, this sums you have to solve it in your max notebook. Coming to the first sum. Okay, multiply the following fractions, 7 upon 9, 8 upon 11 and 3 upon 4. So, I'll write the fractions here, 7 upon 9 multiplied by 8 upon 11 multiplied by 3 upon 4. Now, here 4 and 8. 8 is easily divisible by 4, so you can just cancel it. 4 ones are 4, 4 twos are 8. So, any other number which is divisible? Yes, 3 ones are 3, 3 threes are 9. Okay, so any other number you can cancel? No. So, now directly multiply the numerators. 7 twos are is 14, 14 multiplied by 1, that is 14. 3 elevens are 33. 33 into 1 is 33. So, your answer is 14 upon 33. Just check your answer, solve it and check your answer with this slide. Okay. Multiply all the numerators together. Cancel the number which is divisible with each other. And then you can multiply the numerators together and the denominators together and write the fraction. Coming to the second sum, here there are four fractions to be multiplied together. Okay, so 11 upon 15 multiplied by 30 upon 33 multiplied by 6 upon 7 multiplied by 4 upon 30. Okay. Now 11 and 33. 33 is easily divisible by 11. So you can just cancel this. 11 ones are 11. 11 threes are 33. Okay. 15 and 30. 15 ones are 15, or you can take the table of 5 also. 15 ones are 15. 15 twos are 30. Okay. Now 2 and 30. 30 is divisible by 2. So 2 ones are 2. 2 15s are 30. Again here 3 and 6. 3 ones are 3. 3 twos are 6. Now 2, 4, 7 and 15 in denominator. Is there any other number which you can cancel or divide it? Yes? No. So directly multiply the numerators now. 2 4s are is 8 and 15 into 7. That is, multiply the denominators together, that is 15 and 13, that is 105. So your answer is 8 upon 105. Yes. So check the, just solve it and you can check the answer with this slide. Multiply the numerators together, cancel the common factor, that is whichever is divisible, just cancel it, and then you can multiply the numerators separately and the denominators together and write the fractions. So coming to the properties of multiplication of fractions. Okay, the first property is two fractions can be multiplied in any order. That is, we already learned the properties of addition, subtraction, correct? So multiplication, properties of multiplication of fractions. If there are two fractions to be multiplied, you can multiply it in any order. The answer will remain the same. Now here you can see the example. That is 3 upon 7 multiplied by 4 upon 5. So you can change the order. You can write 4 upon 5 plus first and then 3 upon 7. Your answer will remain the same. Now your second property is three fractions can be multiplied by grouping them in any order. If there are more than two fractions, you can group the fractions in any order. Your answer will remain the same. Now see the example here. 2 upon 3 multiplied by 1 upon 9 into 4 upon 7. So this one, 2 upon 3, you can put it together. That is 2 upon 3 and 1 upon 9, you can put it together and then multiply it by 4 upon 7. Or you can group 2 upon 3 and 4 upon 7 together and then multiply it by 1 upon 9. So any two fractions, that is three fractions, if you have to multiply, you can group them in any order and then multiply. Your answer will remain the same. Okay. Your third property is a fraction when multiplied by 0 results in 0. Okay, that is, for example, any fraction, if it is multiplied by 0, your answer will always be 0. Okay, so your fourth property tells you that a fraction when multiplied by 1 gives you the same fraction. That is, for example, 3 upon 5 multiplied by 1 or 1 multiplied by 3 upon 5, your answer will remain the same. That is, it will give you the same fraction, that is 3 upon 5. Okay, so these are the four properties of multiplication of fractions. Let us revise again. The first one, that is two fractions can be multiplied in any order. Okay, the answer will remain the same. Three fractions, if you have to multiply, you can group them together in any order and then multiply. Your answer will remain the same. Your third property tells you that a fraction when multiplied by 0 will always result in 0. So any fraction multiplied by 0, your answer will always be 0. And your fourth property tells you that a fraction when multiplied by 1 will give you the same fraction. Any fraction multiplied by 1 or 1 multiplied by any fraction, your answer will be the fraction itself. Yes, now based on these properties, let us start with the exercise sums. Exercise 5.2. Question number 4, that is filling the blanks. Okay. Now here, the first sum is 51 upon 64 multiplied by 0. So according to the third property, that is any fraction multiplied by 0, your answer will be 0. Okay. This you have to solve it in your notebook. B1, 8 upon 5 multiplied by 3 upon 7. Now this is according to the first property, that is any two fractions, if you have to multiply, if you change the order of the fraction, the answer will remain the same. So here 8 upon 5 is already written. So here your answer will be 3 upon 7. Okay. Coming to the next one. Yes, 2 upon 7 multiplied by dash into 5 upon 8 is equal to 2 upon 7 into 1 upon 3 multiplied by 5 upon 8. So according to the third property, that is if there are more than two fractions to be multiplied, you can group them in any order and then multiply. Your answer will remain the same. Now here 2 upon 7 is given, 5 upon 8 is given. So with 5 upon 8, we'll write the fraction as 1 upon 3. Okay. D sum 1 into 75 upon 93. That is according to the fourth property. That is any fraction, if it is multiplied by 1, your answer will be the fraction itself. That is 75 upon 93. Okay. Yes, coming to the next one, E1 dash multiplied by 9 upon 11 is equal to 9 upon 11 multiplied by 6 upon 13. Now children, here 9 upon fraction is already written. Yes, so which is remaining? That is 6 upon 13. According to the property, any two fractions, if you change the order of the fraction, the answer will remain the same. And the last one is dash multiplied by 98 upon 101 is equal to 98 upon 101 multiplied by 5 upon 7. So here in this blank, you will write the fraction as 5 upon 7. Okay. Yes. Now based on the topic which we did today, that is multiplication of more than two fractions and properties of multiplication of fractions. Now based on multiplication of more than two fractions, there are two sums which you have to do it in your homework part. That is 2 upon 4 multiplied by 2 upon 7 multiplied by 5 upon 9. So multiply all the numerators together, see whichever is divisible. You can just cancel the common factors and then write the answer. Okay, second one is 5 upon 12 multiplied by 3 upon 7 multiplied by 1 upon 6 multiplied by 2 upon 3. So solve this sum in your homework part. So meet you in the next class with a new topic. Practice all the sums. Thank you for today and see you in the next class.